Hey guys, Yummy here again, and today I'm getting the Mastery Dog Tag for the CBJMS PDW in Battlefield 4. This is suggested by Kevin and Nicola on my last Mastery Dog Tag video on the PKP Pechneg. Just remember guys, if there is a weapon you would like me to master next, just put it down in the comment section down below and I'll definitely consider doing it. Check the description down below for weapons I have yet to master. Now before we get started, I just want to say I got a kill with the Shipunov today. Yeah. Exciting stuff. But anyway, the CBJMS, commonly referred to as the nail gun, when Battlefield 4 first released, was one of the most useless weapons in the game. It was extremely difficult getting a kill with this weapon, along with many other weapons in the game, like the M4 and M16A4. They were just, for some reason, their stats were set up in a way to where it was extremely terrible. I don't really know why DICE just, I don't know what they did to make it so terrible. It just was. Even though it had that 51 round drum magazine, it just was extremely terrible and couldn't kill enemies. So after numerous patches, it is actually usable now, and it can sometimes be pretty hilarious. So I'll just be talking about how this weapon performs and what kind of recommendation I would give it. Now that 51 round drum magazine is pretty much the most standout feature about the CBJMS, other than the way it looks. It is a very strange looking gun. It looks a lot like the Uzi, and it performs pretty similarly to it, but it does have that drum magazine, and that's why it's also called the nail gun, is because it looks a lot like a nail gun if you've ever seen one. And not just because of how it used to perform, that also gave it its name, where it used to do so little damage and it was such a slow fire rate that it was basically like you were shooting nails instead of bullets. But the 51 round magazine, even with a low damage model of the PDWs, does allow you to take out 4, 5, or 6 enemies without having to reload. And I have done that every once in a while, especially when I was grinding those kills on TDM before I got within 100 kills of the Mastery Dog Tag. And it was really fun. It makes you feel so good about yourself when you can take out so many enemies with a non-LMG without even having to reload. By the way, if you guys want to see something funny, here's a picture of some Eastern European soldiers using the CBJMS with a bipod for some reason and a really high magnification scope. Don't know why they're using that gun in particular, but it just looks really goofy and hilarious considering that this is like an SMG in real life and it's supposed to be used in close quarters, not with a bipod and a high magnification scope. But back to the gun, on top of the 51 round magazine, instead of like an LMG that has a really huge magazine but has a really extremely long reload, the CBJMS actually has a pretty freaking fast reload because it is a pistol grip submachine gun or personal defense weapon, so it does have a pretty freaking fast reload. So on top of that and the 51 round magazine, you can put a lot of bullets downrange in a short period of time. It's a lot like the PP2000 that I did the video on a few months ago now, that also had an intro that with a lot of classical music, but it works a lot like that gun, so it can end up being pretty awesome if you know exactly how to use it. Even though the horizontal recoil of this gun had been toned way, way down from how it was before in Battlefield 4, it is actually still quite a bit for a PDW, so it can be difficult sometimes taking guys out of range, which means you pretty much want to tap fire as much as possible to compensate for it, or try to put a compensator on there. But remember, the compensator spreads out the spread even more, so it can be even more difficult to hit range targets, so it might actually make it harder to hit them than without the compensator. And this gun is a lot like the PP2000 in that it has such a large magazine that if your enemy is really far away, if he's out in the open, you can actually kill him with a PDW because you have enough bullets to do all of the damage necessary to kill him. And if he's really in the open, you have all the time in the world to take him out, so you can be slow and patient and manage to take him out. And that's something I really like about this gun, is it's so easy to use at all ranges that you can take out guys at range with it, getting almost completely rid of that PDW range disadvantage. And like all slow firing weapons in the game, like I said earlier, this gun is actually really easy to just pick up and use, since it's got a pretty tight spread aside from some side-to-side recoil with extended automatic firing. You can get follow-up headshots and decrease that time to kill by two or three times. If you can get multiple headshots in a row, this weapon becomes as good at close and medium range as really any other weapon, unless you're really good at getting headshots with a really powerful assault rifle or something. And also, this gun has a really good hipfire accuracy. Like all the PDWs in the game, especially if you add a laser sight, which I don't really do, I'm not a big fan of laser sights, this gun has pretty fantastic hipfire. Within close range to a little bit of medium range, you don't even really have to bother aiming down sight. You could just use hipfire and take your enemies out, and it actually decreases the amount of time in the engagement by enough of a bit that it could save your life. Just by hipfiring instead of spending the time to aim down sights, it could save your life. So there we go, another weapon down and many more to go. Just remember, guys, if there is a weapon you would like me to master next, just put it in the comment section down below and I'll definitely consider doing it. Check the description down below for weapons I have yet to master. And if you guys like this, make sure you hit the like and subscribe button. And until next time, this is me, Yummy. Goodbye and good hunting.